Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to determine that which slope belongs to which, right? So we got the positive, we got the negative, we got a zero, we got the undefined. Now there are only four types of slope you're gonna work on for this section right here. So the positive one is actually quite easy because think of the positives as the one that goes to the right hand side of impossibly. So this one right here, the A, is actually the positive slope right there. So I'm going to circle the A, maybe just draw the A down here for you. So that's my A right there. Hope you can see that. The negative one kind of goes the other direction. So it goes to your left hand side. So what I do is why I remember this. Your right hand side on the graph is always positive, right? And the left hand side is always negative. So if the graph is heading towards the right hand side, that's positive. If the graph is going to the negative side of the graph, that's negative, okay? So there's my negative graph, so that's a D right there, okay? Now, what about a zero and undefined? Well, it's kind of hard to think about, you know, zero slope. What is a zero slope, okay? Well, we know that a slope, we can actually do a little bit of work on the side. The slope is basically rise over run, right? So we got a rise and we got a run over here. The rise looks at the up and down and the run looks at the left and right, okay? Now, if you look at the B right over here, it's going flat, right? So is it really going up and down? It's not. So for B, the slope for the B, there is nothing for the rise. So we can actually put a zero over here. And in terms of the run, it's actually going on infinity, okay? Going left infinity, right infinity. So we can actually just give it, let's say there's a number right here. It doesn't matter. You can say that it's going to the right 5 units or left 5 units. It doesn't matter. It's a number down here. Now, 0 divided by anything, it's still going to give you the 0. Okay? So that's why the B has a slope of the 0. Okay? Now, what about the other ones? The last one right here, the undefined. Well, think about the undefined is that when you punch in the calculator, it doesn't work. So for C over here, let's take a look. For C, you're actually taking some number in terms of the rise, right? Remember, the slope is just rise over run. So there's a number for the rise. However, you don't have anything for the run at all because the graph is going straight up and straight down. So there is a zero right here. Now, try to punch in any number over zero. What do you get on the calculator? It says undefined. So that's why, or math error, okay? So that's why this one here is the undefined, okay? And therefore, for slope number C is my, for this, undefined is for the slope number C right here, okay? I'm just gonna fill in the answer over here so you can see it better. This one's A, and this one is D, and this one's B, that one's a C. So once again, you might wanna remember a couple tricks. If it's going to the right, top, positive. Going to the left, it's negative. If it's perfectly flat, we call it zero. If it's perfectly vertically, it's undefined in terms of slopes. Okay? Thanks for watching.